Hot stocks arriving in the pits at the start of the day's racing. These purpose-built stock cars are made like tanks. The chassis is constructed in a ladder-type formation. Running gear is usually from Ford Transits or Sherpa vans. There are two types of engines usually used, either 3.5 Rover V8s or Ford V6s. Cars are carefully painted and sign written, the roof colour denoting the grade they have reached during the season. Driver of car number 454 is Phil Haig, the equaliser. Which type of surface do you prefer racing on?
There's no doubt about that. I just love shale. Shale is stock cars, yeah. And it's stock car racing. Yeah. Tarmac is racing a stock car, which differs from stock car racing. Yeah. You're actually racing, you've got maturity, your lines. Alright, you can use them. But it's racing, it's not stock carrying. You know, if that's a good description, I don't know, but that's the way I look at it. I tend to struggle a bit on it, on tarmac.
Need more power for the tarmac.
Yeah, you've got to be more conscious of your car set up and tyres. I like tarmac. I'd rather be racing tarmac than not racing at all. Oh, but yeah. I prefer shape.
Yeah. If a sponsor came in and wanted to repaint the car and put his logo on the side of the car, would that bother you?
No. I mean I've been brought up through basically Mike Parker school of
hell drivers.
Whatever, yeah. And at the end of the day, you're here to entertain the crowd. Yeah. And if the sponsor helps you get here and do every meeting, then so be it. You know, I like the setup I've got with the equaliser.
People notice it anyway, don't they?
Yeah, it's good. It's something that the crowd relate to. And all this is gone now, because they can't recognise a car shape. They can't say, oh, there's such a body, with the shape of car. So all the cars are able. So you've got to try and individualise the car somehow with colour schemes or whatever. And I think it's something kids relate to, and if the kids relate, then,
This is a rich snake, Guinness.
I knew you could run away.
Meticulous care is taken before the race over the choice of tyres and the setup of the suspension. The best cars must start at the back, and the first to complete the 15 to 25 lap race is the winner. Last minute adjustments are made and the hot stocks are ready for racing.
Thank you.
Last year's leading point scorer, denoted by the silver roof, was Cumbrian driver Richard Ainsworth.
How do the costs of hot stocks compare to Formula 1? Is it much cheaper to run?
Yeah, a lot cheaper to run.
Is that mainly because of the engine?
Yeah, that's one of the biggest things, is getting confidence in the engine. A lot of work in this job, I suppose. I'll just go and get one out of the scrapyard and run it, but there's a little bit been put in this, people barring out.
Yeah.
Calm it and that, but there is a limit to what you can do, and it's been done.
As well as engine specifications, driver safety also comes under close scrutiny. Helmets are checked before every meeting. The weight of hot stocks also have to come within certain limits.
What about the costs of going from getting to meetings?
Yeah, that is, for me myself, it's one of the worst problems, is travelling for fuel. It's just where we live, we've got that fight alone.
There are some lady drivers competing in hot stocks. One regular racer from Essex is Lisa Harter.
Right, so Lisa Harter, you've come across from mini stocks into hot stocks. Has it been a big change?
Yeah, it has.
Is it harder, hot stocks?
Yes and no. I enjoy the hot stocks more. Yeah. And yeah, it is harder that way.
So.
Yeah.
Spectacular crash there, fantastic crash there, and Edna Ryan, but she's trying to get back in the car, she's fighting to get back in the car, she's with a mechanic to see if they can get that car going again, but I think there's a fair bit of damage there, when Edna Ryan, and in the interest of safety, we stopped that race with a red flag. It could have been a very nasty situation, but a very brave young lady, car number 188,
how do you go on for costs to the car? Is it expensive?
Well, I've got sponsors.
Yeah.
Hands with me, Jim. Then I've got PCM.
Yeah.
And then JP Skips for the tyres.
Yeah. The more sponsorship would always help.
Yeah. Yeah, it's mostly diesel going to the meetings.
That's the biggest cost of it.
Yeah.
Hot stocks race the length and breadth of England and on the Isle of Man. The season runs from March through to November, with one or two race meetings each weekend. So if your appetite's been whetted, you can see hot stocks racing at a dozen tracks up and down the country, with about 50 meetings per year.
Car setup, but yeah, I mean, I'd love a sponsor. Just help with travelling expenses, really, because that's the expense.
Yeah,
going
back to say, are you enjoying your race? You might say, I can't go to Formula 1. But the expense of getting to and from the meeting is the same whether you're in Formula 1 or in hot spots.
That's true, yeah.
Apart from you only doing one meeting a weekend, so obviously, you know, but a lot of lads are working from garages inside the house and whatever, and one meeting a weekend is obviously enough for them. You know, I mean, sometimes I feel not taxed enough, so I need double weekends, but yeah, it's the same.